So far, we have made our application functional. We can load contacts, update and delete contact, upload photo and search their contacts by entering keyword in search form. We also added a complete feature in the search form, but there's one job left. How do we add a new contact group? In this video, we're gonna learn how to create contact group only, but with Ajax. For other operations, such as delete or edit, you can do the same way with previous discussion. Let's take a look at this group button. If we click this button, it should show the text and we can enter new group here. It is not working now. I think I forgot to add the JavaScript in the form, but it's okay. We'll fix that today. First, let's see in the design view source code. Go to bottom. And here we copy this line and in the editor let's open up the form.blade.php file and in the bottom of the line let's create new section, give it name, for example form script, and in this section let's paste the script we just copied from the design. Okay, save, and let's open the main.blade.php file and go to bottom. Here we just yield the form script that we just created. Actually, we could put the script directly here, but remember, if we take this way, the script always load in all page. For example, when we call index method, we do not need the script. That's why we put script in the form. I hope it makes sense. Now reload the page. And try to click the button. Click again. Okay, good. Add group button. Now working. The next thing we're gonna do is add the event handler for this check button. So when we enter something in the text and click this button, it would save it to the database. Also, it would put the select option group with selected. And to prevent empty group, we also perform validation. First, let's add ID to this button. So then we can select with jQuery easily. Let's go to here and let's create the event handler for add new button. Here we perform AJAX, and for the URL we call the route groups.store. The method post and the data, just the name. We prefer the success function and error function. Okay, now let's create the new route. And here we create route with pulse verb. So we access groups slash story and use groups controller and method store. We can use root as groups.store. Again, this class is still not exist, so let's create that file. And here we generate the controller. Now let's open up the file. Let's create a method called store, and the parameter request, and for now just echo 1. Okay. Reload and inspect the element, click, and we get the error here. Yeah, I think we have to add token to that Ajax. Back to the form lid, and here we add token. For the value, we select from the hidden field. Let's see in the and here. So we call input with name underscore token, and we get the value. We can also call the CSRF token underscore token function, and it would generate token for our form, but it would generate the same token with our previous token. So I change to before. Now click OK. It tells us that we have success communicate with server. As I mentioned before, we would make sure that the group is valid. So before we save it to our database, let's validate it first. I'm going to use server side validation because client side validation I think is too risk. To do this, it's very simple. We don't need to use third-party library or plugin. We just do the same way with the previous discussion. Laravel validation is very smart. It will not generate a redirect response when Ajax call. Instead, it would generate a JSON response containing all the validation's error. Okay. Here the validation. Now let's go back to browser, reload the page, keep the text blank, and click the button. Here we got error that say name is required. With this error return, we can show it to our form. Here we convert the XHRA message to JSON response. Because the error name is array, we get the first message. When there's error, we get the parent that is input group, and add has error to make input border red. Also, we show the error message below that below the input group. Okay, let's save and back to browser, reload the page, try to enter nothing and click the button. There we go, we got the error message, but here we got problem when we try to click the button again, it would be there to message, click again 3 and so on. So before we show the error message, let's delete the previous message, if any. Here we get the pattern, and remove previous error message, if any. And after that, add new error message. Okay. Save. And let's go back to browser. Reload the page. Try to enter nothing. Click the button. The message show up. Click again. Click again. Okay. I think it's good. Our validation is working. Now it's time to save the valid contact group to our database. Let's jump back to Groups Controller. Here we load the group model and in store method, after validation, let's save the group from request object. And of course, we have to define the field in fillable attribute in the group model, or we get misassignment error. Okay, now let's go back to our browser, reload the page again, and enter something here. And click the button. It seems nothing happened here, but let's reload the page again. And you can see here our new group is saved. Cool. We have success to save new contact group, but it would be nice if the new contact group is add to select group. So here we assign group create method call to group variable. This variable contains new ID, name, and other attribute. Since we need JSON data, we call response object and convert it with JSON method. Now let's go back to form.blade.php file and let's modify the ajax to success function. Okay, we check if success, then we make a little change here. Okay, first we get the closest div and remove error message if any. And after that, let's add new group to the select. We select by name, group ID, and we append option, new option to the select. We provide value from response, and also we check the option to selected. And after that, just clear the text. Okay, reload the page. Enter something here. Click the button. I think there's typo here. Okay. Reload the page again. Enter something here. Click. Okay. New contact group now show in the Slack. Alright, today we have learned how to add new contact group by Ajax and Ajax server-side validation as well. I hope you find something useful. If you have any problem, feel free to comment. Thanks for watching.